자.
Hey, how's it going, everybody? It's the Game Economist back with another PvP guide for Dark Souls 3. Today we'll be using the Follower Saber. Before we begin, I just want to mention that the invasion footage will no longer be at the end of my PvP guides. From now on, they're going to get their own series, right? And I think I'll even do a little bit of educational work on them, some commentary, and the same quality gameplay. Alright, well, let's move on to talking about the Follower Saber. So, the Ashes of Ariandel DLC came out, and with it came a fucking nightmare to PvP. It was called the Follower Saber, and it had the most annoying weapon art that if you got caught in, basically, you know, like, took half your health, and it could roll catch you to death, and yeah, it was very, very, very frustrating. Several nerfs later, you have this, you know, very sad boy type of Follower Saber where it is very hard. It takes skill to roll catch with it now, right? You have to delay your R1 just right to roll catch with this weapon. And the two-handed R1 is pretty short range, in my opinion. And yeah, everything about this weapon feels significantly weaker. And it's kind of in this new meta where the question is, why would you ever use this? Because you have the Pontiff Knight Curve Sword, which still does really well. By the way, Pontiff Knight Curve Sword has the longest range of all the Curve Swords by a lot, which is why From should probably step in and lower the AR on that weapon so that it still feels unique, it's still got its range, but it's not totally dominating the best weapons in all the tournaments, right? Think of the Washing Pole. Washing Pole was a nightmare, and then they came in and nerfed it, and now it's still really good, right? You've got Demon Scar. Why would you use the Follower Saber over Demon Scar? It almost makes no sense. Demon Scar has Fire Surge, Black Flame, which you can true combo into, and the Chaos Bed Vestigious, which admittedly, you know, very skilled players don't get hit by that very often, but if they do, they're in a lot of trouble. And then finally, you have the Dark Scimitar. So if you wanted a Dark Infused Curve Sword, and the reason you might have that is to deal chip damage through a Black Knight Shield, you would probably just use the Dark Scimitar. The only big, you know, the only, I want to call it the draw for using the Follower Saber has to be the weapon art. It's got this unique weapon art that guard breaks a guarding opponent very quickly. And so when I was taking it out into the arena and I was testing it, what I was discovering is that even that weapon art isn't that great, okay? That's kind of the final thing I discovered about it. Even that weapon art is no longer that great. You use it on a very skilled opponent who knows that it can guard break quickly. They're not gonna try and guard it, they're just gonna roll. There's a little telegraph right at the beginning of the weapon art. It's a big tell. And, you know, as soon as you detect it, you just go, he's going into the weapon art. You just start rolling away, start getting away. The most consistent time to use this weapon art on the Follower Saber is on an opponent who is panic rolling because he's trying to gain distance from you. He's trying to get safe, you know, he's trying to get away from you so that he can start recovering his stamina. Well, if you can get him while they're panic rolling, there's a fair chance you'll eat him up and maybe even land the R2, maybe. But let's say you're using it in a neutral stance. You can't just start it winding up because virtually any weapon can trade into this weapon art. The early swings of the weapon art only deal like 120 damage. That means anybody who knows what they're doing can happily trade with the weapon art at the beginning. They don't guard it, just trade with it or roll away from it. At the same time, the R2 at the end, the one that deals all the damage and it has hyper armor, very easy to parry. So you're always kind of at risk with that as well. So the weapon art ended up feeling very, I want to call it mediocre. At the same time, you've got the very nerfed roll catch on this weapon. The one-handed moveset, you'd use it with the Black Knight Shield. The one-handed moveset, it just wasn't fast enough, it felt like, and it wasn't long enough range. It made me question, why wouldn't I just use like a Lothric Longsword with the Black Knight Shield? There was one thing. I did like the running attack. The running attack was really nice. However, the running attack on the Dark Scimitar is really nice. I could just do that, right? You don't have to have the Follower Saber for any reason at all. So, if we're just looking at it and comparing it to all the weapons in the game, I do have to say it's still a fast weapon, right? It's still a curved sword, guys. So it's going to do quite well. It's going to, I would say, around B tier. But then after I used it for a while, I really realized a lot of the upper tier fast weapons dominate this quite well. and even some of the ultras, some of the poise weapons like the halberds, in particular the halberds were difficult because they had such a good range advantage. They're just difficult enough that I feel like this kind of slides right into B minus, low tier in the B tier, right? And that's where it's going to have to be until From takes another look at the game balance, if they take another look at the game balance. Now, should you use this over the Karthus Curved Sword? I don't know. I need to go play with the Karthus Curved Sword. I suspect the Karthus Curved Sword might actually have an advantage over it. So where this weapon art has a pretty good, It has a pretty good forward momentum. I believe the Karthus Curved Sword's weapon art isn't parryable, is that right? So it's actually kind of a decent non-parryable option for opponents. If you're predicting that they're going to parry you, you can go into the weapon art. So, Karthus Curved Sword might even be a better option. Alright guys, well I appreciate you watching. Let me know if you enjoyed the new format, and I'll see you next time.